Good morning, No Finish Line Nation. It is August 18th, 2017. It is a beautiful summer day. It's the only August 18th, 2017 you're ever going to get, so make it the best one that you can ever get, right? But I'm going to describe the situation right now. I'm sitting in my office and I'm on camera and I'm talking into this ginormous microphone that I have sitting in front of my face. I'm wearing my power superstar superhero glasses, my white glasses, the white frames that I have on every once in a while when I want to feel sassy and want to feel a little bit strong and empowered. And I've also got my Liquid Chano 1973 Coffee Talk shirt on. And it talks about, as the photo shows on the shirt, I've got the brain on one side and the coffee on the other. So I feel empowered. I feel like I can take it on. And I feel like it's a great way to be able to kick off the Coffee Talk. Now on the video, you can see me. Right, you can see what I'm looking at. I'm pointing to you right now. I'm looking at you, pointing to you, good to go. But if you're listening to me on the podcast, I know you feel these white glasses that I'm wearing. And I know that you know that this dark shirt on with the white lettering for Coffee Talk is shining and smiling back at you right now. Okay. So the last couple podcasts, we talked a lot about positivity. We talked about taking the negative thoughts that you might have about yourself and turning them into positive thoughts. We talked about weighing them out, balancing, negating them, moving that on, right? So that was the first part of the framework of the conversation we were having. And I had a conversation with a few people, and we talked about how you have to make it a habit. And to make it a habit, you got to do it for 30 days. You got to do it consistently over and over again. You got to keep working at it. You got to keep on trying to drive that behavior and continue to take your negatives and outweigh them with positives and continue to work on that. Make that part of your challenge, right? And then the second part of that was, of course, to take down something that you are most positive of, are most proud of, whether it's the one item that you're most proud of or it's the top five items that you're most proud of. List them out and know that you can use them in the future for your ad. So it's a recap, but everybody knows that if you've been listening to any of the podcasts, that's really where we've been parking. But today's a little bit of a different podcast. Today's about how do you navigate the wobble? Let me explain myself. So for me, I'm talking to my sister on the phone today and we got some internal family stuff going on. I'm talking to my wife. She's got some internal family stuff going on. The ground starts shaking a little bit and you're thinking to yourself, oh man, you know, I could easily slide back into a binge of food. I can easily slide back into old bad behaviors of what I had before. I can do all kinds of items that I used to do whenever life would be stressful or when life would get in the way or it would come at me or it would look at me with this big fist and want to punch me right in the face, right? All of us have been there. We've all been there. So at the end of the day, thinking positive about yourself, listing out the things you're most proud of, and negating the negatives with the positives is easier said than done when life happens and it comes at you full force. And it's like a hurricane gust of wind coming at you. And I get that 100%. So this podcast is all about how you navigate the wobble and how you are able to navigate through that. So let me explain that wobble piece of it. So when I was growing up, and of course, as you could see with the 1973 on the end of my shirt and on the title of my persona here on the podcast with Liquid Chano 1973, you know how old I am. So when I was growing up, I played with these little toys. They were about this big and they were shaped like an egg, but they were called Weeble Wobbles. And the Weeble Wobble, we would sit in the middle of the kitchen floor, my sister and I, or just myself or whatever, and we would flick the side of it and it would start bouncing back and forth and it would wobble to the side and to the right and to the left and all over the place. And it would never fall over, but it would always come to the center and stop, but it would take a really long time getting there. And it would wobble and it would wobble over and over again, right? And it looked chaotic all the time. So when you would flick it, you'd be like, it would almost be mesmerizing to kids because you're looking at something that's so chaotic, but then it eventually will come to it and it'll come into play where it's going to come to a solid ground, solid footing, and it will find its way. So when I think of that, when I think of a Weeble Wobble, I think of our lives. I think of those moments where if I'm talking to my sister about family issues or I'm talking to my wife about family issues, that's the big hand of life going bonk and hitting over to the side. And now I'm weebling and I'm wobbling and I'm going back and forth and it's nonstop. And I'm feeling like, oh man, I could slide right into that binge. I could easily drive right through that drive-through of that fast food restaurant and cheat on my meal and really kind of dig in and just eat my feelings right now. You know, I always talk about the fact that I'm always on the verge of a binge. It's hard to say that when you're a food addict, but when you admit that, you can empower yourself to be able to fight through that. So for me, I'm always battling that urge. When stress happens, even when celebrations happen, I'm always battling that. So my ground a lot of times is jumping all around. It's earthquake style, right? So I'm looking like MC Hammer when he's dancing back and forth on the stage because I'm just trying to find my footing. Or if I'm on a boat and you're rocking back and forth and you're sitting there just trying to keep your legs straight. When I was in the Navy, that's one of the things that we used to call them sea legs, because we would be so used to rocking back and forth on the boat, we would hit the shoreline. As soon as we'd get on land, you'd see us rocking back and forth. We'd be walking side to side and tilting left and right because our body became acclimated to it. So the thing that I wanted to talk about here is how do you navigate your wobble? How do you navigate the wobble? You can look at the wobble as being something as bad, right? Because life is happening. Oh my God, I feel like life's coming to an end. I feel like I'm having a really bad situation with this whole thing. And the wobble can be viewed as a negative thing. But I look at the wobble as a positive thing. Now again, here I am. Again, I take a negative and I turn it into positive. Here's why I look at it as a positive thing. Because again, like I said before about antiques and looking back on worn down furniture or things that have a lot of character behind it, the wobble also builds character. The wobble prepares you on how to treat that wobble when it happens again in the future. The wobble builds your character and it thickens your skin so that you're able to fight back against some of those feelings and some of those things that you might be battling through whenever the wobble happens. So when you look at the wobble, don't look at it as such a detrimental, traumatic situation. I felt a little bit of that today, and that's why I'm talking about it tonight, or this morning, sorry. And the reason that I'm talking about it is because I'm thinking to myself, if I'm feeling that, if I feel like the world's crumbling around me, I need to arm myself with the tools in my tool belt to be able to fight through that. So we talk about your tools, we talk about things like listening out your whys, and we talk about things like making sure your categories of importance of the things that you want to be able to fight for. Those are really important things to talk about, and those are important things to discuss and use whenever the wobble happens. So for me, I thought to myself, is it really worth it for me to slide through that McDonald's drive-thru and get that double quarter pounder with French fries? Or is it really worth it for me to eat my feelings at that moment in time? Yeah, it might feel good at that moment in time, gratifying, be able to just kind of get that urge out of the way, knock it out, be able to do what I got to do. But how would I feel afterwards? I'd feel guilty. I'd feel downtrodden. I'd feel negative. I'd feel worse than I did before. And the wobble I thought felt really bad. I would feel even worse after, as I'm kind of that little weeble wobble just starting to slowly shake back and forth, but now I feel guilty about everything that I did while I was in the wobble. So the reason I share that is because when the wobble happens, you have to be prepared for it, because it's going to happen. Wobbles will happen. I know that I should have a shirt that says that, shouldn't I? Wobbles happen. It should. I should definitely have a shirt made that says wobbles happen, because it does. It's a reality of life. If you think you can just go around talking about unicorns, rainbows, sparkles, and all kinds of good stuff, you're probably going to be in bad shape by the end of it. Because if you think that that's what life's all about, you're wrong. And if you've lived any life already, you know that that's not the case. So if we arm ourselves and we prepare ourselves with how to be able to navigate through the wobble, I really feel like at least when it gets here and it faces us in front of us, we have a slight framework, some sort of mindset that's built in for us to be able to attack that and be able to bob and weave. Now, bobbing and weaving is an old boxing term. Of course, course, you got your guns up like this, and you're bobbing and you're weaving, and you're coming in, you're jabbing, you're bobbing and weaving. Dominica, you know exactly what I'm talking about. So you're coming in, you're bobbing and you're weaving. It's the way you're playing defense, but you're also ready to pounce on the offense. Well, the defense side of it is, normally I'm in offensive mode. I'm in a positive place. I'm positive influence. I'm attacking things. I'm getting in front of it. I'm doing everything. But when the wobble happens, I then have to tone that back a little bit and become defensive. And not defensive as in I want to fight back on anybody or become defensive like attitude-wise. I mean defensive as in I'm ready to take it on. I'm going to bob and I'm going to weave as the waves come in, as I've got the negativity or I've got the life that's being dished my way. It's my way of being able to go, okay, I can get through this because I'm ready. I got my armor on. I got my skills going. I'm stretching. I'm all stretched out, ready to go. I'm ready to take it on. And the only reason that works for me is because today would have been a great day that I literally would have felt better. I felt at that moment in time to go and do something like hit the drive-thru or eat something I shouldn't have. But you know what I did? I hunkered down. I grabbed my little bar, my protein bar that I had in my car. I ate that. I grabbed my water, my 80-ounce jug of water. I drank some of that and I got home and I had some delicious dinner with the family because it was my comfort zone. I knew that that's where I was going to. I was going to sit with my family, even with drama going on, and have some dinner with them. And it was low points and it was great. Now, I did this and I feel good about this because this was a decision that I consciously made. I specifically said to myself, and a thought went through my mind, instead of going with the urge or the emotion of that aspect of it, I consciously made an effort and a decision to not do that and make a better decision because I know I'd feel better about myself. And quite frankly, this morning, I feel good about my decisions. I feel good about where I'm at with it because I did that for me and I was ready for the wobble. Are you ready for the wobble? Are you ready for something to happen? Because it's going to, like I said, it's going to happen. So do you have your armor on? Do you have your armor ready? Are you ready to slap on that tool belt and for you to be able to say, I can take this on? If not, start thinking of that today. Start thinking of how will you respond to that negative situation? How will you respond to old man life that's going to come at you and slap you in the face? Because when it happens, it hurts. It puts you in fits of depression. You get down in the dumps, those kind of things. But if you're prepared for it and you, not that you have to expect it to happen, but when it does happen, you're ready to at least be able to bob and weave the wobble. Listen to all these terms I'm using, right? Bob and weave the wobble. But I'm just kind of spitting this stuff out there. So it's kind of how I'm feeling about it because I felt really good about my situation as I was on the phone with my family and going through the stressful parts of that situation. But by the end of the night and this morning, I feel really good about the whole situation because I feel like I navigated my own end of it pretty strongly and firmly and got through it, whatever I had to get through. Knowing that today it may happen again, but I'm stronger and I'm wiser to be able to take it on as it is faced my, or as it comes my direction and I'm faced with that kind of scrutiny or that kind of suffering or pain or those kind of things that may come my way today. I'm bigger and I'm stronger than I was yesterday for me to be able to attack it today. Okay. So I hope that helps you out a little bit. It's just more of a reflection point for me. Prepare for your wobble. It's going to happen. Think to yourself, you don't have to be you don't have to have perfection when you're preparing for your wobble. You also don't have to battle through the wobble perfectly, right? As it's going. But you just want to make sure you set yourself up for some form of success as you're going through it to give yourself some data points, some little thing for you to be able to say, I need to grab onto this when life becomes that roller coaster and I'm rolling through it and life is crazy and it's chaotic and I don't get what's going on. I need to grab onto the following things for me to stay positive and keep pushing through. Have a great day, everybody. We'll talk to you guys later. Thanks a lot.